The 2.0 update for the Discord Stream Deck plugin is here, and it's full of exciting improvements. Let's dive in. Discord introduced Soundboard functionality right into the app, and with the new Soundboard action, Stream Deck can trigger those sounds directly, to the delight of everyone in the voice channel. Browse the list and click to highlight the sound to play, or search for a sound using the text box just below the title. Note that you must be in a voice channel for sounds to play, and will need to be a Nitro subscriber in order to play sounds between servers. Switch between your wireless headset and your broadcast setup with the new Set Audio Device action. This action can set your input between different microphones or inputs, or set your output device between headphones or speakers or anything else. Want to switch between headphones and speakers and back quickly? Use a multi-action switch. Speakers on the first multi-action, and headphones on the second multi-action. Each time you press it, Discord will flip between those devices for your output. Keep tabs on a server's activity with the Server Stats action. Display current active users and show how many messages have come in recently. In the options, you can choose the server to show, if you want to show new message count, and display all online users or just the recently active ones. Tap on the key to go directly to the last message in the server. Besides servers, you can now see how many notifications are waiting for you with the notifications action, and who keeps pinging you nonstop to look at this picture of a cute pupper. They're pretty cute though. Tap on the key to be taken to your notifications. Change if you are in push-to-talk or voice activity mode using the voice input mode toggle action. Great if you need to go hands-free for a bit. One thing you all kept asking for was the ability to adjust other users' volume directly from Stream Deck. With the user volume control action, this is now possible with the turn of a dial on Stream Deck Plus or the tap of a key. But this doesn't mean your friend gets off the hook for yelling into the microphone. In that same area, you can now adjust your input and output volume using keys or dials, using the volume control action. You can also make a key with a preset volume, like 68%, or another with 124%. This looks a lot like Volume Controller. By the way, check out our video on that awesome plugin here. Lastly, the voice channel action has been updated to display how many people are in the channel when you joined, the most recent speaker appearing on the key. Thanks for watching. Let us know what you think about the Discord plugin, and what maybe you've been wanting. If you find these update videos help, why not give us a like and subscribe? Because you won't want to miss more content on how to get the most out of your Stream Deck and other Elgato products.